orchestrated it.
You are the God of.
Oh, Jesus. Hey. This ain't the end. I got to tell somebody. I know it feels like it. This ain't the end. We're just in the middle. My God. Jesus. Hey. He had to break it off of your life because you wouldn't let it go. My God. Hey, what he has for you is greater. I know it's uncomfortable because we've gotten accustomed to our own things, our own ways, our own desires, our own appetites. Ooh. Oh, God. Oh, Jesus. Hey.
You are the God.
Yet to come. That means he's in your situation currently. He was in your situation yesterday. And he gonna be in your situation tomorrow. Oh, Jesus. We come to acknowledge you today. Ooh, yeah, God. We came to pour our praise out today like oil. You can read our weep, God. Hey, God. You know the number of hairs that are on our head, God. Oh, God, we bless you. We give you glory today, God. Altars in this place. Close your eyes. He wants to talk to you. He wants to show you something. Hey, God. Ooh, the Ruach of God is blowing through the room right now. The wind of God. Ooh, Jesus. Hey, he's blowing refreshing. Ooh, strength across you right now. He's blowing strength on you today. Thank you for the oil today, God. We thank you for the balm in Gilead today, God. Oh, Jesus. Hey, God. Hey, God. We serve you as problem solvers. Hey, God. Forever and always, God. Oh, Jesus. Help us to remember that. Allow it to calibrate us, God. When the enemy comes for our peace, when he comes for our joy, God, oh, Jesus, help us to remember, God, you're forever and always in our life. You're always present. You love us today, God.
Hear the sun today.
Oh, Jesus, your love got us to this place. Your love made arrangements for us, God. Your love is intentional, God. Ooh, you didn't just accidentally love us. You didn't fall in love for us, God. You didn't fall in love with us, God. You stood on that cross. Ooh! You took a beat for this love. My God! You were bruised! were pierced,
God,
in the name of love.
Save the world.
Yeah. Hey, God. Ooh. Ooh, your love didn't drop us off. You're still with us. You're still with us. Oh my God, somebody's tired of fighting the way of the Lord. My God. Oh Jesus. Oh my God. Touch our situations, God. Oh Jesus. Touch our situations today, God. Manifest your glory. Ooh, fill us up today, God. Strengthen us, God. Prepare us for the things ahead, God. Ooh, Jesus. Allow us to see the plots and plans of the enemy. Allow us not to be focused on the problem, God, but keep our eyes focused on you as the problem solver, believing that it's working for our good. Knowing that it's working. If it ain't finished, it's still working. Ooh, allow us to be patient as those things are working. Oh, Jesus. Hey, God. Forgive us today, God. Forgive us as we murmur, we complain, God. We were mad when you closed the door, but death was on the other side of that thing. Jesus! The thing we want was gonna kill us, God. Ooh, change our taste buds today in this atmosphere, God. Purify our taste buds today, God. Ooh, Jesus. Purify our taste buds today, God. Purify our desires today, God. Some of us have never had our taste buds purified, God. We still like the taste of that thing that you called us out of, God. My God. Hey, some of us don't do it. Hey, because we know it's not righteous. But if you gave us permission, we would still do it. The taste is still in our mouth, God. Purify our taste buds, God. Heal our taste buds, God. We call on you as the balm in Gilead today, God.
You are the
answer. We don't need to see. We don't want to keep self-medicating, God. Hey, you're the doctor that gets it right every time. First shot. My God. The doctor's got to switch from medication to medication, and that didn't work. And add this medication, take it at nighttime. But God, all we have to do is say, Jesus. Hey, God. By no other name can man be saved. Oh, Jesus. Hey, God. Somebody's being healed in this atmosphere. Even online, somebody's being healed. The emotions are being healed. I can't rush this moment. Oh, Jesus. Oh, hey, God. Hey, God. Hey, God. Hey, God. Hey, God. We're in the operating room today. Somebody's having a heart transplant today. Hey, hey, God. It was just a couple left. It was a couple.
You gotta say, do it in me, God. You gotta say, do it in me, God.
Yes, God.
Oh my God.
Jesus. Jesus. Oh, Jesus. In case you forgot, he got the whole world in his hands.
Yeah.
That means your situation, your child. My God. Jesus. Hey, he's got the dope dealer and the drug addict in his hands. My God. Everything he does well. Woo!
The beginning.
Jesus.
And I know the
Woo.
End.
Bless your name, God.
Yeah. I know the beginning.
Come on!
And I know the
My
end.
My Lord!
And
Woo, Jesus. Woo, Jesus.
All I ask Woo. Is that you trust me.
To Makeover Transformation Church, my God. As I used to say back in the day, we welcome you once, we welcome you twice, my God, we welcome you three times, my God, hallelujah. I was glad, my God, when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord, my God. Ooh, Jesus. I have a short scripture reading for this morning. When y'all want a core, you really don't have to talk to each other, because I promise you, Prophetess Julia got up here and said everything I was going to say. Listen, hey. You don't have to talk. So scripture reading is from Jeremiah 29 and 11.
All
right. We know this one, but I just had to take you to the word this morning and remind somebody. I know I'm not preaching, but I feel this all this morning that somebody needs to hear this. You may be online. You may be in the house. But somebody needs to hear this. Jeremiah 29 and 11 and 12. I'm reading the New Living Translation. It says, "For I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. They are plans for good and not for disaster, to give you a future and a hope. In those days when you pray, I will listen." Listen, God reminded me this morning that sometimes we're going to go through some things.
Yes.
I'm getting up here as co-pastor, and I'm telling you guys, I do not cross every T,
come on.
And I do not dot every I. Sometimes you are going to go through some things, but God said he's speaking to somebody's heart this morning. He's speaking to my heart this morning. Let me be transparent. He said, "For I know the plans I have for you." It may look bad. It may feel bad. Your heart may break through this thing. Woo, Jesus. It might feel like you're losing your mind through this thing. Nobody around you might not be doing what he's called you to do. My God. Nobody in your family may have done it before. But God said, "For I know the plans." Woo, Jesus. As he was ministering this to me this morning, as I was on this altar, God was saying that he was reminding me of the three Hebrew boys. And God just keeps taking me back to those three boys. Because in this season, we're going through some fire.
Yeah.
You might as well get your safety clothes on.
Yeah.
Go ahead and get your fire extinguisher.
Yeah.
Because in this season, you're going to go through some fire. But God said, "For I know the plans I have for you." It was in that fire that people got to see that Jesus can show up even in the midst of a ugly situation, even in the midst of a situation where it feels like you're about to die. Can you imagine walking through some fire? Somebody in here right now, you feel like you're walking through some fire. You walking through poverty. You walking through depression. You walking through anxiety. You walking through some things. But God said, "For I know the plans I have for you." This has not caught me by surprise. This is all a part of the plan. See, you think that you're backsliding. You think that you missed the mark. You think that God has somehow forgot about you. But he said, "For I know the plans I have."
Yeah.
You're trying to figure this thing out by yourself. You can't figure it out. You can't figure out why that person keeps coming up in your life. My God. You can't figure out why that co-worker keeps treating you crazy. You can't figure out why everywhere you go they keep talking about Jesus. You can't figure out, my God, why you can't sleep at night. Because God said, I know the plans. I know the plans. We got to get that part. I know the plans. You don't know this plan. You don't know how this thing is going to work out. But God is saying on this morning, don't let your heart get too bitter in this season. Don't get too brokenhearted going through the fire, because this is a part of the plan. This is a part of the purpose. This is a part of it. This morning, let me tell y'all about just a little fire I had to go through this morning. Because this is how I know. It's been coming down my street, and I know the oil trickles down. So with my week, the devil been trying me all week, and I've been going through some fire. You're not going to sit out there and tell me you ain't been going through some fire. So I've been going through some fire all week. I mean, everywhere I turned, from work, I moved out of my apartment this week. Everywhere I turned, it was like, okay, here's some fire. But see, I know my word. The devil got the right one when he tried me, because I know that the Bible says all things work together. So I can't worry about the fire. Yeah. Let me get back to where I was at. So this morning I was on my way to church. And this whole morning was just, I'm just being honest. The devil didn't want me to get here. Yeah. And so I'm on my way. I go to Starbucks because, like I said, this morning was crazy. I'm like, I need some coffee. I'm going to give me some energy this morning. And I get there, and literally, I mean, my coffee spilled from my head to the end of my dress. And I had every reason to get upset. I had every reason to go back home and use that as an excuse to change my clothes and wind up being late and wind up not being able to get up. But when I really thought about it, I said, this is in the plan too. If I turn around and go home and I don't make it, that is only me letting the devil succeed. See, you have to acknowledge when you fall into the trap, you're now allowing the devil to have havoc in your life. I refuse to let the devil do anything in my life or yours. You better tell Satan to sit down somewhere. I don't care what it looks like. I don't care how bad it feels. I don't care if you got to cry yourself to sleep every night. Listen, I will give each and every one of you my phone number. I give strangers my phone number, because I refuse to let Satan, I refuse to come in contact with somebody and let Satan have havoc in your life when God already has decreed and declared that he knows the plans he has for you. Before you walk on this earth, God already knew what he was going to do in you. Do not get distracted in this season from the things of God, because God is saying we are right at the brim of breakthrough, y'all. Right? We're right there. I mean, it's right. Our foot, our big toe is already through the door. And that's why the pressing is so hard. I'm going to try to get out the way, because I'm not preaching this morning. But I need you to know, as co-pastor, I need y'all to know, the fire, listen to me, this ain't God, this ain't me, this is God. The fire is coming. The storm you got to walk through, it's coming. That testing, the temptation, the exes, it's coming. That crazy co-worker, it's coming. Those distractions, they're coming. But God said he knows the plans he has for you. Do not get outside of his plans. But here's how much God loves you. One of my favorite things the Bible says in Lamentations, I think it's 3:22. It says his mercy refreshes each and every day. So even if you slip a little bit. See, I got to speak to somebody's broken heart, because this is deliverance ministry for real. Even if you slip a little bit, even if you was on the phone with him last night, my God, even if you backslid this week, God said, I still am going to work out, and that is why I made it to where my mercy would afresh each and every day. Because I'm not going to let you get outside my plans. You can run and do it. Listen, I did everything. I tried to do everything I could to get out the will of the Lord my whole life. I every time he would get me right there in breakthrough, I would turn around and let the devil defeat me. And I'm telling y'all, it's coming. It's coming. It's coming. But just as I told y'all a couple weeks ago, God's still God. So Satan can do what he want. The world can do what they want. The family members can do it, but he's still God. So it's still going to work out for your good. Jesus. So I'm going to pray us in. I pray that really gets in your heart this morning. Because I really feel some broken hearts in this place. We're not going to be like the regular church as usual and act like everybody in here is living a perfect life. I don't care if you're from Providence down to the baby right there. We got issues that the Bible says many are the afflictions of the righteous. So you can sit there with your dress on and your legs crossed, your tie and your legs crossed. But I know that some things is running up on you, and God has sent me here today to say, I still love you. You haven't got too far from me. My God. My mercy is still sufficient for you. My grace is still sufficient for you. So I'm going to pray us in and get on out the way so the preacher can preach. Y'all, I'm preaching this Friday, though. So be here. Those online, be here. I'm preaching Friday so y'all can get a whole word Friday. Okay. So, dear Heavenly Father, we thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Lord, that your grace and your mercy does afresh each and every day, God. We thank you, Lord, that we can't go too far outside of your will, Father God, without you coming after us, oh God. We thank you, Lord, for your joy, your peace, oh God, that surpasses all understanding. Your love, oh God, that covers a multitude of sin, oh God. Ooh, Jesus, we thank you, Lord, that your blood covered everything we went through, oh God. Every situation we decided to put ourselves into, oh God. We thank you that your love was sufficient enough for that, oh God.
Yes, God.
We thank you, Lord, that in the midst of everything going on in the world, oh God, that we've got a same mind in this place. That we still have an obedient heart to show up to church on this morning. That we still have an obedient mind, oh God, to wake up worshiping and praising you, oh God. We thank you, Lord, for teaching us, oh God, the sacrifice of praise and worship, oh God.
Yes, Lord.
Woo, Jesus. We thank you, Lord, for fresh strength on today, oh God.
Yes.
Lord, I pray that you would send down your glory, oh God, and renew our strength, oh God. We need some renewings in this place, oh God, for the battle that we are going forth in, oh God. For we know that the battle is not ours, oh God. So, Jesus, we ask you, Lord, to meet us, Father God, in our battles, oh God, to show up, oh God, like only you can, God, and to fight on our behalf, God, because we come humbly today, oh God, without pride, oh God. We come humbly today, God, saying that we can't do it by ourselves, oh God. We come today, Lord, laying at your feet, Jesus, saying that we are not good enough by ourselves, oh God, that the world can't teach us how to do this, oh God, that we can't use our hands to do this, oh God, that we can't use weapons to do this, oh God. But, Lord, we come to you today, Father God, saying we're laying at your feet, Jesus, and we need you, God, like never before, oh God, to show up in us, oh God. Lord, remove the scales from our eyes, oh God. From any, Lord, open up our eyes, God, to see any distraction, oh God, any plot, oh God, any twist, Father God, any turn, Father God, anything, Father God, that is not from you, oh God, anything that is or isn't from you, God, open our eyes, God, so that we can see, Father God, clearly, Father God, so that we can walk after you, Jesus. Lord, help us to see, Father God, if we're being led astray, oh God. Help us to see, oh God, if we're being led by a stranger, oh God. Help us to see, oh God, if we've turned the wrong way, oh God. Lord, give us dreams on this week, oh God. Give us visions on this week, oh God. Give us divine connections, oh God, to line up with the will of you, Father God. Lord, help us to acknowledge your plans on this week, Jesus. We want to get more in tune with the things that you have for us, oh God. Lord, block out any distraction in the name of Jesus, Lord. Purify our minds, oh God, so that we can think clearly, Father God, so that we can have a sound mind, Father God, so that we can stay steadfast and stand firm on the things that you speak to us, oh God. Lord, open our ears, oh God, so that we can hear clearly, oh God, Jesus, what you are trying to say to us, Father God. Ooh, Jesus. Purify our hearts, oh God. Search our hearts today, oh God. You found anything in us, oh God, that's not like you, Jesus, remove it now, God, in the name of Jesus, Lord. Ooh, Jesus, touch us, oh God, from the crown of our head to the soles of our feet, oh God. Lord, we need you on today, Father God. We don't come, Jesus, asking for anything else but you today, oh God. Lord, when the word goes forth, oh God, let it be you, oh God. When we pray, Father God, speak through us, oh God, let it be you, oh God. Jesus, when we meet people today, when we run into people today, oh God, let it be you, Jesus. Less of us and more of you today, oh God. Less of us and more of you this year, oh God. Next year, oh God. For the rest of the days of our life, oh God. Lord, help us to stay in tune, Jesus. We don't want to get off track, Father God. We believe, Father God, that it is the last days, God. And that time is winding up, oh God. And Lord, we want to stay on the winning side, oh God. We want to stay on the undefeated side, oh God. We want to stay with you, Jesus. So Lord, wrap us up in your arms, Father God. Close every door, Father God, that has not been opened by you, oh God. Lord, make a way out of no way, Father God, for you said you would make an exit, oh God. You would open a door, Father God, for us to get out of the things that are not of you, oh God. Father, each and every person in this place, oh God, Lord, I ask that you would open a door, oh God, of escape, oh God, for anything that is not of you, Jesus. I pray that you would make it clear, oh God, crystal clear, oh God, that it's not of you, oh God, so that they can't run, Father God. Jesus, give us the endurance on this morning to move forward, God, to run, Father God, from the lion that roars around trying to get us, oh God. Oh, Jesus, I thank you, Lord. Lord, send your glory in this place, God. Send your oil in this place, God. Anoint us afresh today, oh God. Oh, Jesus, help us to know, Father God, what you want to do in this place, God. What you want to do in us, God. Lord, reveal any gifts to us on this morning, oh God, that we're not using, Jesus. Help us to open our mouths, oh God, when you ask us to, oh God. Help us to move our feet, oh God, when you ask us to, oh God. Lord, we want to move forward, Father God, when you require it, oh God. We don't want to be a day late or a dollar short, oh God. Help us to line up, oh God. Oh, Jesus, for we know that the things of God are for real, God. We know that you are the true and living God, and that everything works together for a certain time and certain place, Father God. Jesus, help us to be there on time, at the right place, Jesus. Don't let us miss the mark, oh God. Don't let us pass it up, oh God. Don't let us move forward, oh God, if you called us to stand still, oh God. Don't let us stand still, oh God, if you called us to move forward, oh God. Lord, help us to go where you tell us to, oh God, no matter what it looks like, Jesus. No matter what it feels like, Jesus. No matter if it doesn't look like you, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Lord, I believe that your word is true, Father God, that when we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, that you would be with us, oh God. So, Lord, as you move us forward, Father God, I know that there will be valleys, oh God. I know that there will be darkness, oh God. I know that there will be lows and highs and mountains, Father God. But, Lord, all I ask today, Father God, is that you be with us, Father God. For you said that you be for us, Father God. You're greater than the whole wide world against us, oh God. That included darkness, oh God. That included mountains, oh God. That included valleys, oh God. So, Lord, I just ask you, God, be with us, oh God. Lord, help us to call out to you in the time of trouble, oh God. Help us to teach us, Father God, that all we have to do is say, Jesus, Lord, Jesus, Jesus. Lord, teach us the power of calling on your name, oh God. Teach us the power of calling out your word, oh God. Teach us the power of getting in the word, Father God, and allowing you to minister to us, oh God. Lord, give us a new desire, a fresh craving, a fresh appetite for the word on this week, oh God. Lord, help us to dig deeper on this week, oh God. Give us fresh wisdom today, oh God, fresh understanding, oh God. My God, for your word says, what profit a man to gain the whole wide world, Father God, and lose his soul, Jesus. Help us to get in tune with our spirit man on this week, God. We don't want to be carnal, oh God. We don't want to do it the way the world tells us to, oh God. We don't want to do it the way mama told us to, oh God. We don't want to do it the way that some of these church leaders tell us to do it, oh God. But we want to do it the way that you tell us to do, oh God. We don't want to have a religious spirit, oh God. But we want to have a true relationship with you, oh God. Lord, teach us, oh God, that you are the bridegroom, oh God. Lord, comfort us in the midnight hour, Jesus, when we're by ourselves, God. Comfort us in our prayer closet, Jesus, when we come to you, God, and we know that all we have is you, Jesus. Lord, strengthen us today, oh God. Yes, God, remove any rejection in this place, God. Oh, Jesus. Remove anything in this place, oh God, that's not of you, God. We come against the spirit of abandonment in this place, God. Oh, Jesus. For I believe, God, that if you show up, Father God, it has to fall off, Jesus. So, Lord, I ask you, oh God, to send your son to walk through these aisles, oh God, and touch us today, oh God. Because we don't have room for distractions. We don't have room for wicked spirits, oh God. So touch us fresh today, oh God. Each and every one of us, God. We don't want to be touched by people, oh God. We don't want to be touched by messengers, oh God. We want a fresh touch from you, Jesus. Because there's something when you yourself show up, oh God. Show up in dreams, oh God. My God. Oh, Jesus. Teach us to have a one-on-one relationship with you, God. oh God. We surrender to you, Jesus. We lift up a sacrifice of praise today, oh Jesus. Speak through Providence Julian today, oh God. Send forth the word of healing on today, God. Send forth the word of comfort on today, God. Send forth the word of deliverance, true deliverance on today, God. Send forth the word of bondage breaking in this place, oh God. Send forth the word that will break the yokes of the enemy in this place, oh God. Jesus, move in the word, Father God. For I believe that the word is living, Father God. For you said the world will pass away, heaven will pass away, but the word remains the same, God. Do it in your word today, God. In the name of Jesus, I do pray. And we give you all the honor and all the glory, Jesus. Amen.
Cause when you
morning, y'all. Perfection. My God. Whew. God, we bless you.
Yes, God.
Thank you, Lord.
Jesus. Ooh, we honor you today, God. We call you perfect.
Yes, God.
Call you perfect, God. We call you perfect. We don't understand holy perfection. You said our thoughts are not your thoughts. Your ways are not our ways, God. But we come today with our small, finite minds, to the best of our ability. Humbly, we call you perfect. We thank you for your perfecting spirit that lives in us, God.
Thank you, Jesus.
That purifies us, that purges us, that corrects us, that loves on us. You're perfect. May we focus. May we focus on your perfection, on your love. We focus on your love. For God so loved. For God so loved. We don't even understand so love.
Yeah.
My God. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son so that whosoever believed in him shall not perish. My God, all you got to do is believe.
Yes.
Jesus. When you don't believe, you got to say, Lord, help my unbelief.
Yes.
Yes.
I want to believe. I believe you in some areas, but help my unbelief.
Yes.
You said, whosoever believe in you shall not perish.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to perish. I feel like parish is running up on me. It's on my hind. My God. It's breathing down my neck. It's on my back.
Yes.
This thing is trying to make me crumble. But you said all I have to do is believe, God. I believe. But help my unbelief.
Yeah.
My God. Failed relationship after relationship. Is there a such thing as a good man? Help my unbelief.
Yes, come on.
Jesus. He's better than nothing, God. I'm just going to hold on to this. I mean, he kind of come to church. Help my unbelief.
Oh, yeah.
My God.
Jesus.
Help my unbelief, God. Help my unbelief, God.
Jesus.
Help my unbelief, God.
Yes, Lord.
I've wasted so many years. If I give up now, I've wasted all of those years, God. And I'm older now. My God.
Jesus.
Oh, Jesus. Hey, God. I hear somebody's heart today.
Thank you, Jesus.
Help my unbelief.
Hallelujah.
If I let go of him, I'm going to be lonely, God.
My God.
Hey. Help my unbelief.
Yes, God.
I don't even know how to let go, God. Help my unbelief. Oh, Jesus.
Yes.
Jesus, help my unbelief. Help my unbelief. Oh, God, we bless you. We honor you today, God. Have your way in this place.
Yes, God.
In our hearts, in our minds, in our situations, in our circumstances. Have your way in this place. In Jesus' name we pray. Hallelujah. And amen.
Amen.
Ooh, put your hand on your chest. Say, have your way.
Have your way.
In this place.
In this place.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Thank you, God.
Ooh, God is so faithful. The weight of glory is just in the room. That's the peace of God you feel. You didn't even get high, y'all. Nobody rolled up nothing.
Bless God.
Okay. I'm just trying to tell you, the world think you got to roll up to get peace. We're beyond the veil. That's that peace. Like you could just literally lay down and go to sleep right now. It's the peace of God. It's that calm. I tell you all the time, worship, it gets you there. You gotta learn how to worship until you bring this in your own home. My God. Whew. God is so amazing, y'all.
Yes.
I just can't even tell it all. He's so good. Today our message is called Appetite Control. Appetite Control. I said, all right, Lord, well, what you about to talk about? I love God, y'all. He's so good. He's so good. Let's go to Matthew chapter 5 and verse 6. Matthew chapter 5 and verse 6. Chapter 5, and we're going to start at verse 6. Courtney, do you got it?
Yes.
Can you read it out loud for me?
Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled.
My Lord.
Come on.
Blessed are those that hunger after righteousness.
Come on.
Come on, after what?
Righteousness.
Come on, because they're going to be filled. The world leave us thirsty, y'all. Come on. We keep on going back trying to drink from those wells. But they leaving us thirsty. The Bible says you have to hunger. You got to be hungry for the word, for the things of God. And you got to thirst after righteousness. My Lord, that's why Jesus told us you got to eat of my flesh and drink of my blood. They didn't understand that. They didn't understand that. Because yes, they were following God, but they were carnal minded. The carnal mind doesn't understand spiritual things. You can still be in church, love God, and still have some worldly thinking. Not all areas, some. Let me give you Bible. Peter, when Jesus said, who am I? Who do you say I am? The Son of God.
Hallelujah.
Jesus said, flesh and blood did not reveal this to you. My God. And so when he said, you hear from God, you got to be hearing from God to know that. There's no other way you know it.
Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah.
Flesh and blood did not reveal this thing to you. We understand that there we can hear spiritually, but then there are some times that we can be off. We can go down a different road. Baby, it's all right. Listen, this is just a door. It ain't gonna send nobody to hell or heaven. I promise you, I don't lose my mind about things in here. It's all right. We can get that off. It's all right. It's all right. We get too upset about accidents. Honey, she's a baby. If that's the worst thing to happen in your whole day, you good. Trying to tell you. It's real. We have to hunger and thirst after righteousness. We have to hunger and thirst after righteousness. We have to be to have that desire for the things of God. And if you don't have a true desire, if you only have a desire to read your word when you in this place, you only at home in your church, whatever those things are, you gotta say, Lord, birth a hunger in me for righteousness. Those that hunger and thirst after righteousness, we shall be filled. My Lord. Because your appetite's always there. That's what I got to tell you. We might not have thought about it like that. But your appetite is always there. How many times you eat a day? Okay. Somebody said more than you should. Yes. So then you have to think about how many times are you feeding your spirit?
Oh my God.
My Lord,
body's full, flesh is puny. Spirit is puny. Flesh is strong. That's why you can't overcome things. Because your flesh is strong. It roars. It tells you what to do. And that spirit may be like, don't do it. But it's like the run. If you're not feeding it righteousness.
That's why
we're stumbling. That's why we're backsliding. Pressures don't change. You might have a next level, but pressure gonna be there. Trouble gonna be there. Tests and trials. Like, just get that. I think that's just so concrete in my life that I'll be like, okay. Like, that's why that didn't bother me.
Come on.
We were sitting in the bed this morning, me and Demetrius. He was sitting there and he was having too much fun. He spilled a whole cup of juice in my bed. He was like, oh, shoot. I said, it's just juice. Get a towel. Things are going to happen. I say it all the time, the people of God have to have some consistency about you. Everything can't make you lose your mind. We got to, okay. The car is wrecked. You done lost your whole mind. Baby, it's not going to make the car go back together. What can you do? Just breathe. Okay. Just breathe. We got high blood pressure because we don't know how their problems happen. I mean, at what age do we realize problems happen? They're going to happen. Just get it in you. They're going to happen. All right. Don't panic. Problem solve. The Bible says we are called to be peacemakers, not hellraisers. Which one are you? When something roll up on you, which one are you? Are you carnal minded? Are you worldly minded? When things go wrong, if you're worldly minded, you're going to be a hell raiser. Come on. If you're spiritually minded, you're going to be a peacemaker. All right, let's figure this thing out. That's the best kind of parent you can be. We cause our children to be hyper-minded. Then they call it ADHD and everything else. Because anxiety, thank you. Yes, because we raise them so, everything is, Even when my kids were younger, when I would wake them up, I do think I got that right. Thank you, God. I bless God. When they was little, I messed up a lot, y'all, but I think I got this part right. When they was little, I would always go in there when it was time to wake them up, and I would lay my hand on their back, and I would rub their back in a circle, and I would, even when they were, like, I mean, up some, like, this tall age, rub their back in a circle, and I would say, you know, good morning. I would pray over them. I rub their little head. Sometimes I'd give them a foot massage with lotion, because I think they should be woke up peacefully. Well, when I ended up paralyzed and couldn't walk, I had to have one of my really good friends that has gone on to be with the Lord wake them up. And she's like a drill sergeant. And so I was in my bed down, so I couldn't walk, so I couldn't do nothing, y'all. And all I heard was, get up, 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 get up. I said, oh my gosh, you finally gave my kids a heart attack. Because they're not used to that. You know? So we got to think, we have to really problem solve in a way that is going to give glory to God. So the Lord can always be shown through you. Takes that peace. That peace. Those that hunger and thirst after righteousness shall be filled. I'm going to read it out of the NLT version because this just blessed my soul so good. I mean, the Message translation. Let's see, Matthew 5 and 6. You're blessed when you've worked up a good appetite for God. He's food and drink in the best meal you'll ever eat. When you've worked up a good appetite for God. That's how when you in the car, you headed to church, you like, Jesus, see me, like, see. And then you get here, and they like, oh, she stirred up, and I done worked up this appetite. I'm ready. Come on. I worked it up. Because we used to work it up when we was in the street. ready to go do, you listen to it in the car to work up your appetite for what you was about to eat, to act upon.
Yeah.
We got to think about that. So you got to learn to set your day up that way. We're going to have us a blessed day. Listen, I got to work this appetite up for God before I go out here and bite somebody. Come on. All
right.
It's just the Bible.
Come on.
I'm just telling you. Let's go to Philippians. Philippians 3. Philippians 3 and 17. Philippians 3 and 17. Dear brothers and sisters, pattern your life after mine's and follow and learn from those who follow our example. For I have told you often before, and I say it again with tears in my eyes, that there are many whose conduct show that they are really enemies of the cross of Christ. Wait a minute, look up here, because I need y'all to get that. I know we saying we love God, but the Bible says your behavior can show that you are an enemy of the cross of Jesus. My Lord, you cannot be at your job cussing people out. My Lord, at home cussing your kids out. You are showing that you are an enemy of the cross of Christ. In somebody else's bed that ain't yours, you are showing that you are an enemy.
My Lord,
being disrespectful to your parents, you are showing that you are an enemy of God. Help us. Dressing in a way that's inappropriate. You are showing that you are an enemy of God. Whoo! Ain't that heavy, y'all?
Yeah.
Hold on, verse again.
3 and 18. Philippians 3 and 18. Verse 19. They are headed for destruction. When you do that, you're headed for destruction. Their God is their appetite. Their God is their appetite. What they eat, what they desire, what is your, what you like. Their God is their, oh, that ain't my girl. Here they go. I just like weed. I can quit anytime. You've been smoking in 73 years. When do you think is a good time?
Oh my God.
All right. Their God is their appetite.
Yes.
What does that mean? That's just how I do stuff.
Jesus.
Your opinion, your ways. You worship it. You're set in stone on that thing. God know my heart.
Helps.
Yeah.
Come on. It's against God, but you still like it. That's your appetite. And you worship it. You're saying, not your way, God, my way. You're saying, not your will, God, my will. My Lord. My Lord. Their God is their appetite.
Yes.
Their desires. What they enjoy, what they do in their free time, their Friday nights. Change our taste buds, God. Change our taste buds, God. We don't want to have worldly taste buds. We want our whole palate to be clean.
Yes.
Come on.
Yes.
Our whole palate to be clean.
Yes.
We gotta process that.
Yes.
You know how when you eat something or when you brush your teeth, some people like, they like, I like to eat before I brush my teeth, or I like to brush my teeth before I eat. Whichever way, it's because you want your mouth to taste a certain way. My Lord, it's the same way. You want to make sure that what you're ingesting. When I'm praising God, I want my palate to be clean. if I still like it, God, but it's against your will, take the desire away.
Yeah.
Sometimes he'll take it away, and sometimes you got to lay it down.
Come on.
He's not going to keep on, because he's already made a place for you to lay it down, and you didn't lay it down. I call that exceeding grace.
Jesus.
When the Lord sends a word your way, if you don't stop instantly, he's not going to be like, well, I don't got enough to do with you. He's going to step back.
Mm.
Have your way. Because warning, it comes before destruction.
Yes.
He sent that word because you don't have no more times.
Mm.
I heard a lady preach one time, and it just really, I was a new babe in Christ. And she said the Lord had, she was sleeping with a married man. And she said, the Lord had called me out of his bed and told me, you know, we was laying right there together. And the Lord told me, don't you do another thing with this man. She was a minister. And she said, it was going to be New Year's, how clock strike 12. And she said, I told him, after midnight, I'm not doing nothing else with you. So if you would like to enjoy another party, we're going to have to come on in the room now.
Ooh.
Yes. The Lord said, stop. She said one more time. And she continued to tell her testimony. Time passed and she was talking. She said, now I stand here bald headed with lupus.
Ooh.
She didn't equate the two, but I knew she exceeded grace.
Mm-hmm.
You cannot exceed grace.
Glory.
When I was leaving the woman that I was married to, the Lord told me to leave. I was laying in the bed. I heard him clear as day, said, leave tonight. But I had planned to leave tomorrow. The house was peaceful, quiet, everybody was chilling. I'ma leave tomorrow. When I left tomorrow, it almost cost me my life. Baby, I learned how to stop at the stop signs. Come on. And everybody was like, oh, I can't believe she did that. I said, baby, this ain't her fault.
Yeah.
God told me to leave. We don't take accountability.
Yeah.
I always trying to blame it on somebody else. When the deal was done and she was like, I'm sorry. I said, girl, it ain't even you. I've been forgave. I was disobedient.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Had no business being in this situation.
Yeah.
Being in this place. Do not pass the stop signs of God. Sometimes we pass the yellow, and I always tell God, Lord, I be moving too fast and I stop, I pass the yellow. But if it's a stop sign, I mean, listen, make sure I get it. It's dangerous to pass the stop signs of God. You don't know what it's going to cost you. You his child. He loves us. When he closes a door, don't you go open it. When he tells you it's not good, accept it. Doesn't matter if you like it. Nobody asked you, do you like it? Kids don't like vegetables, but they're good for them. We don't like medication, but people take it. And it's nasty. But we take it because we think it helps.
Mm.
How much more should the word of God have rule in our life?
Yes.
Yeah.
Our appetites have to be renewed.
Yes. Thank you, Lord.
They have to be transformed. The Bible says their God is their appetite. They brag about shameful things. And they think only about their life here on earth. My God. That's how you know. That's how you know right there. Because you're just worried about your own pleasure. You're not thinking. Listen, I promise people say don't preach a hell and what they call it? Brimstone message. I don't know. Yeah, hell and damnation. They say don't preach it, baby. I promise that's how I got saved.
Come on.
When I realized I still liked it. Everything that I used to, I still liked it. But I said, wait a minute. This Bible says I'm going to hell.
Yeah.
Oh, no, it ain't that good.
Yeah.
It ain't that good. It ain't that good. I can't worry about my appetite. That's why the Bible says these kind going out only. No other way. Can't have hands laid on you for that one. Only by fasting.
Yes.
got to starve that appetite that's been created in you. You've been eating it like this so long. You've been doing that thing so long. My God. You can't even understand life without it. That was my testimony. I cannot even think. What?
Come on.
So, well, I ain't even no good men in this world. What? Amen. Come on. That's how I thought. That's what I really thought. Ain't no faithful men in this world, Lord. That's what I thought because I've been eating that thing so long. What you mean you can have peace without weed? That ain't even no sense, Lord. It's natural. Come on. My grandma, she's 97. She ain't got a wrinkle on her face and she still smoke weed. It's got to be the answer.
Oh, my God.
You've been doing it so long. Everybody around you still has those taste buds. Come on. Jesus. We've been cooking food with fat backs and gristle and all that in it for so long. What? Eat that with it? Girl, that is, I'm not about to eat. I ain't got no seasoning on it. But it's killing us.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
And we feed it to our children.
Yes.
They developing a taste bud for it. I don't believe diabetes and high cholesterol is passed down through bloodline. It's passed down through what we put on that table. It's passed down through recipes. You put it in their mouth. My God. They are babies. They don't know what it tastes like. Whether it got sugar and butter, if you take it fresh off the tree, mush it up and give it to them, they're going to eat it.
Yeah.
We put all of that stuff on it.
Extra.
Come on. We passing down diabetes.
Yes.
Every time we set them in front of
it. Help us, Lord.
We passing down high cholesterol. Every time we set them in front of it. They don't even like real food.
Right.
If it ain't McDonald's, it ain't good.
I know
it. It's processed. They like the taste of processed food. Eat these fries without ketchup? What? That don't even sound right. My God. Help us.
Yes.
We need appetite control.
Yes. Come on.
If somebody said, here, take this loaded gun and put it to your child's head, you're not going to do it.
No, it's not.
But you do it every time you put them in front of the table. Yeah. And the food ain't good for them, not to them. That's what we're doing. We're playing Russian roulette. Because you might have been good. You might be good. You might have diabetes your whole life and you was able to control it with medicine. But they might just lose a limb. Mm. You don't know. Close the door.
Come on.
Close the door. Close the door. Kids, now you can't get mad at them when they smell marijuana in your house their whole life growing up.
Yeah.
Then you mad. It's natural, mama. You did it. Daddy did it. Grandma did it. You can't get mad. And you can just say, I never had a bad experience. But you don't know what to roll up on them. Somebody could lace it the first time they smoke. It happened to one of my friends in high school. To this day, he is.
My Lord.
Close the door. We have to have our appetites changed.
Yeah.
Why my daughter want to date men that's broke down, beat battered, and disgusting? Come on. Because you still dating them. They just got a tie on. They carry a Bible, but they don't live it. They know a scripture, but they still in your, they bind you Victoria's Secret. We are not married. Why are you bind that? My God. They ain't never got a Bible verse when you're going through, but they keep a bottle of wine.
Come on.
My God.
He's not of God.
Jesus.
He's not of God. You want your children to do right, your appetite has to be correct.
Hallelujah.
And sin is never satisfied. So you don't know how it's going to hit their life.
Yeah.
You being in a gross, abusive, broke down relationships, it just opens up the door for them. And then the devil have his way.
Come on.
Yeah, your husband only beat you, but hers killed her. You don't know.
Jesus.
We have to have our appetite corrected. We eating stuff that's killing us, y'all. My God. Woo. We eating stuff that's killing us. It's not God's desire. Your appetite is controlled, is connected to your destiny. You eat to live. That's the one thing you cannot do on this earth. And I promise you, I really believe that's why that is the hardest struggle. Eating is one of the hardest struggles, because you, if you get delivered from crack, you don't have to do crack again to live. Come on. But if you have an eating disorder, it's a battle every time it comes breakfast. It's a battle every time it comes lunch. It's a battle every time it comes dinner. It's a battle every Easter dinner. It's a battle every Thanksgiving dinner. It's a battle every Christmas dinner. My God. People got here getting lap band tummy tucks and all of that stuff, baby, but that thing is still in you.
Yeah.
We're correcting it from the outside. But the appetite is still in me. It's lust. Desire. It's a battle every time. The first sin was over what Eve put in her mouth.
Amen.
The Lord said, "Don't eat it."
Don't eat it.
And what she do? So this ain't new, y'all. We've been struggling over don't eat that. It's not good for you, but I still like it. I like the pleasure it brings.
Amen.
My God, it feels good to me.
Amen.
Tastes good. Hey, God.
Come on.
It's still true. It's the word of the Lord.
That's good.
What you're eating, it represents what you take in.
Mm-hmm.
What you take in. Not necessarily in your mouth, but what you take in. The music you're listening to. You're eating. You're feeding your spirit.
Yes, that's true.
Come on.
Come on.
You're going through a rough time and you're listening to all the sad music and you wonder why you're depressed. Now you're sitting at the doctor's office, got to get medication. I don't know what just happened, doctor. It just seemed like it rolled up on me. No, you done been listening to sad songs. This is another sad love song.
Come on.
All day long. Have a seat, Demetrius. Have a seat right there. Don't you get up. What you're feeding your, I don't know why I stay angry all the time. I got a rage problem and all you listen to is kill, 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 kill.
Yeah.
I mean, it's still real.
Yeah.
I got one for you. I don't know why my child is rebellious and they listen to, what's that song? Can't nobody tell me nothing. Come on. It sounds harmless. It sounds harmless, y'all. I promise, if you don't be mindful of your music selection, your spirit is eating. People call me churchy because I don't listen to worldly music. I don't care. Call me what you want to call me.
Come on.
Thank you.
My God, because that thing rolls up. When you got a problem, those lyrics roll up.
Hallelujah.
If you don't think there's no good men and you listen to all the songs about Mr. Me and Mr. Jones got a thing going on, you're not going to think that.
That's true.
Come on.
Yeah.
Your music, it feeds you.
It does.
Yeah. The television shows, the things you see, they feed you.
Oh.
It ain't even your choice. It's not your choice.
Yeah.
Your spirit is always hungry. It's as little as you flip the door, like, oh, I'm going to get my hair cut like that. You just got fed.
Yeah.
You just got fed. That is a cute outfit. You just got fed.
That's it.
Come on.
Yeah.
you struggle with homosexuality, you see a rainbow with a couple on there doing extra stuff, huh? Just a seed got planted.
Come on.
You got all of these cartoon shows with all the kids disrespectful and ignorant to their parents, but it's a cartoon. It's okay for them to watch that. Caillou is so bad.
Come on.
He's on KET, and I mean, it's harming. The music is nice. Caillou's over at Tom Crazy to his mama, throwing plates on the floor. What? Come on. And your child is watching it. They're eating.
Amen.
But they want to put them on medicine. My God, they've been eating all day long. What we heard, what we see, what people speak over our life, the things that we listen to. We've been eating. We need appetite control. That's why I say it all the time, cut the TV off. Come away from it. We have formed opinions over what we see. We gotta do better. Because it's gonna cost us more than we want to pay in this next season. I can't afford it.
Come on.
I just can't. It's too high.
It is.
Jesus, help us. Let's go to James. I need somebody to read it out of the NLT version. James chapter 1, verse 14. James chapter 1, verse 14. What you allow to nourish you will fill you. When a seed is planted, it goes down in the dirt. Eventually, the thing gonna sprout forth. It's gonna grow. It's going to bring forth fruit. James chapter 1, verse 14. Has anybody got it? 14 and 15.
Yeah.
Okay, read it for me.
Temptation comes from our own desires, which entice us and drag us.
Wait a minute, hold on. It comes from where?
Our own desires.
Lord! My mama made me do it. It comes from where?
Our own desires.
Jesus! The TV made me do it. It comes from where?
Our own desires.
She made me cuss her out.
Come on.
You've been wanting to cut somebody out today. She just happened to be the one.
Come on.
Because that's real, y'all. Because I be like, sometimes I be ready to preach, and it just be bubbling in me. And then somebody say, how you doing? I be like, good. I be like, God, you, girl, let me tell you, honey. And it just come out. I've been ready to do
come
this
on.
Thing.
Come
on. Be bubbling in you.
My God.
Come
yeah.
on.
Yeah.
Come
yeah.
on.
Yeah.
Come from your own desire. Go ahead.
Yeah.
And drag us away. These desires give birth to sinful actions.
Wait a minute. Your desire, what you wanted to do, because you didn't hold tight, it done gave birth.
My Lord.
It done grew up, done gave birth. Now your mouth is like it's flapping.
Ooh, my God.
Jesus. Your own desires. My God. Your own desires. Go ahead.
And when sin is allowed to grow.
Oh, God, when it starts, keep growing.
It gives birth to death.
Jesus! Ooh.
My Lord.
Woo! Your own desires. Help us. The message translation says, the temptation to give in to evil comes from us and us only. We have no one to blame but the leering, seducing flare-ups of our own lust.
Temptation.
It's that feeling. It's the thought. Come from your own lust. The Bible said a flare-up. Jesus. I love the message translation. It just, woo. Come on. We have no one to blame but the leering, seducing flare-ups of our own lust. Lust gets pregnant and has a baby, sin. Sin grows into an adult and becomes a real killer.
My God.
And it's just a thought. I mean, that's harmless. They can watch Disney Channel with that on there. seed being planted as a young child. My God, those seeds that are being planted, then they grow up. They're growing up.
Amen.
Hallelujah. They grow up.
Amen.
Then a flare up happens. Situation comes to pass. And then lust gets pregnant. My God. Come on. You know, something else done joined. The situation is a joining. You was molested as a child. Then something happens. That seed of perversion has already been in you.
Oh my
God. My Lord.
That seed of perversion is already in you. People trying to cut the fruit off. Baby, this thing is rooted in me.
My God.
Anger, rejection, rebellion. It starts early.
Amen.
Then you grow up. Meet somebody. Connect. Why? Because y'all got the same brokenness. When you find a man or a woman outside of the will of God, 9 times out of 10, you're going to struggle. Because y'all connected on some things that are not of God. It found a partner. Gets pregnant. 2 become one flesh. Now we walking this thing out together. Has the baby. Oh, Jesus. We see fruit in your life now.
Amen.
It's starting to manifest. Well, I don't know why he got a tilt to his hand. He was born like that, girl. He been like that since he was 3. No. If he was born like that, it came down through generations. Nobody stopped and said, not my life, not my seed, not my family. My God, nobody said, I got to put a stop to sexual sin because I don't want them born with that monkey on their back. My God, sin is birthed. Now they walking in that thing. Why he got on the whole dress? Now they're walking in that thing. Now you're in that relationship. Y'all both got into it, bonded over y'all's brokenness. Now y'all 2 broken people laying up fornicating. Sin is birthed. Time y'all, we trying to figure it out. My God. And when sin grows up, becomes a killer. What I thought was good.
That's good.
The picture was pretty. I thought this was the life for me. Come on.
Yeah.
I heard somebody just the other day, they was in a situation and the guy was gay and he said, I don't want to be around gay people. I said, that's how you know right there. It's how you know it's not well with your soul. It's not well with your soul. Mm-hmm. You think it is. It's deep seated in you. Because your appetite hasn't been washed. Grows up to become a killer. The thing that you think you like becomes a killer. It becomes a killer. Help us, God. Purify our taste buds. The things we like are killing us. And eating is actually a blessing. That's why the Bible says those that thirst and hunger after righteousness, it shall be filled. The devil will always, he knows the word. That's how he knows. That's how he know what to do. He know. That's why the world be kind of grushy thirsty. Come on. The devil know if he keep giving that thing to you. He keep feeding that thing to you. He keep on letting every channel you turn on. You like, dang, I'm trying to get away from this thing. But every time I turn on the TV, that's why I just had to, whenever the Lord was delivering me from vanity, I had to get off Facebook. I had to get off of TV. Honey, I just had to look this close at myself and the word of God. I couldn't even, because it's everywhere.
Yeah.
It's everywhere. You have to be intentional about being delivered. It's not going to accidentally roll up on you. You got to be intentional. This thing can't keep having its way in my bloodline. We got to set up generational legacy. I'm tired of talking about generational curses. I want to set up generational blessings. My God. But it starts with me. It starts with you. Somebody got to stand up and say, not my family. If I got to be the one to sacrifice first, it's well with my soul. It's well with my soul. It's well with my soul. Because what I'm eating, I'm feeding to my children. And whatever you eat, it kills you. Let me tell you. Good or bad. Whatever you eat, it can kill you. Let me tell you the good one. I love this scripture. Those that live by the sword, they die by the sword. When the Lord revealed that scripture to me, he said, if you live by my word. If you live by my word, I'll kill that flesh. Every time I opened up, everybody, what? Wait a minute, I'm sitting up giving. What? This is all. Help me, God.
Come on.
Live by the word of God. If it says it, it's right.
Yeah.
It does not say if you like it. Come on. He said the truth shall set you free. We can't be free because we're not getting the truth. We're not getting it ourselves. They preach a sugar-coated gospel, talking about a spoonful of sugar make the medicine go down. Hey,
Lord.
I don't care about that.
Lord.
Jesus, what we're eating, it is killing us. You have to have self-control. I love because we always want, I need somebody to call and remind me. One of my friends, every time I see, girl, just call and remind me. Girl, you are a whole grown woman. You better put a timer or set a calendar or something. Self-control. 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 It's a fruit of the Spirit, so you don't even have to do it by yourself. You got the Holy Spirit. It produces love, joy, peace, patience, gentleness, kindness, meekness, long-suffering, and self-control. You don't need an accountability partner. It's the Holy Spirit.
Ooh,
it was deposited in you. It's that little voice that says, don't do that. It's not loud. We're so used to loud. We think everything got to be loud. Everybody buzzing us upside our head. It ain't here. It said, no. You just didn't feel right. Come on.
Yeah.
It's your personal accountability partner. Yeah. You can do it, but you ain't comfortable doing it. Self-control. Because sin is an appetite issue. It's what you're hungry for.
Yeah.
What am I hungry for? Whatever you're hungry for, you're going to go after. When you're hungry for money, you're going to go. You're going to make sure, listen, what I'm going to do is go to work.
Come on.
They call it work ethic determination, but the hunger is money. Because there's a difference between providing for your family and being money hungry. Your kids don't need Jordans and PlayStations. They just need shoes on their feet. Come on. We going broke. Buying dumb stuff that they gonna grow out of. You ain't got no house that you own. They ain't seen you. You ain't taught them no lessons. Come on, you just buying stuff, throwing it at them. Husbands buying big wives and big houses and big rings for their wife and can't even be faithful.
Oh, come
on. Jesus. Come on. What is he feeding you, woman of God? That's how you gonna know if he's of God. What he feeding you? Don't come over here with no pork chop and no Heineken. Don't do that. Okay, you got a Coach purse and some Versace shoes. Cool. But you feed my flesh. My God. What are your friends feeding you? Everybody can't be my friend.
That's right.
That's right.
Because when I call them and I'm having an issue, they can't feed me the flesh. They're going to contaminate me.
Yeah.
Rich. Come on.
It's real.
Yeah.
schedule, she'll say, she'll let me talk to you. She'll say, well, do you still love him? It's gonna work for you good if you still love him. That's all, you know. I'll be like, well, bless God, hey, all right, well, that was good. Come on. That's it. The people that are feeding you, what are they feeding you? That's how you weed out your circle. Mm-hmm. Are you feeding my flesh? Mm-hmm. Or are you feeding my spirit? Because it's only a matter of time. Flesh, that stuff, it don't, that's only so good. That's okay, it was fun, but you know. That's going to wear out. Oh, you bought me a brand new car. Okay, the brand new car. Oh, it's so exciting, but. All right, now the thrill is gone. What else you going to get? Come on. It's kids. That's kids right there. Can you buy me a new toy? We just bought two toys yesterday.
Two toys, just two.
See what I'm saying? Greedy. Let's be greedy for God. Yeah. Let's be greedy for God. Let's go to Galatians 5. Galatians 5. Verse 16. So I say, let the Holy Spirit guide your lives. Then you won't be doing what your sinful nature craves. When you follow after the Spirit, you won't do what your sinful nature craves, what it desires, what it's hungry for. The sinful nature wants to do evil, which is just the opposite of what the Spirit wants. And the Spirit gives us desires that are opposite of what the sinful nature desires. These two forces are constantly fighting each other, so you are not free to carry out your good intentions. Good intention ain't enough. I'm going over his house, girl, but we just gonna watch a movie. Girl, we are not about to do nothing else. Right. Good intentions are not enough. You have to say, this decision that I'm about to make, is it feeding my spirit or is it feeding my flesh? What is going to be satisfied in this? Because as this shift is taking place, it's a shift taking place. Mm-hmm. And as this shift takes place, you have to have self-control. You cannot bite everything that is given to you. The Bible says, be in the world, but not of the world. If you don't have self-control, you're going to be in the world doing the world. Yeah. Jesus! I was doing a wedding party yesterday, y'all, and they was playing all the music that was not that blessed. And I was like, Lord, have mercy. But I've been there, so no judgment. No judgment. But it was interesting to me because I asked the Lord to birth a hatred in me for worldly music. Because why? I want to do club ministry. If I got to go to the nightclub, I can't be praying with somebody. Y'all shut him. Wait a minute. Which side do you want me to pray for you? Man, come on. You have to have your taste buds purified. So that when the Lord sends you out, my sister sent me a sermon. Some man was in the pulpit and he was just going on and on. And he said a whole cuss word.
Oh.
That's because your taste buds ain't purified. And what's in you comes out. You cussing at home, preaching in the pulpit. Mm-hmm. The Lord said, I've told you time after time.
My God.
He pulled the cover off of that. It's real.
Yeah.
It's real. Your taste buds have to be purified to do the work of the Lord. We cannot have selfish desires, even as a parent. When a parent is selfish, you're going to always put yourself before the child. I mean, I know they need school clothes and stuff, but these new J's just came out and the new PlayStation game, so I'll get them next week, my next check. We have to empty out of selfishness to be a good parent. My Lord.
Our taste buds have to be purified. These kind go without only through fasting and prayer. You gotta starve the flesh. Fasting is so important because it allows you to have control. You're in that moment of, what do I bite when I'm hungry? If you're fasting, you don't have to do, it's good to do an all no food fast. But to me, I think a Daniel fast is great because you got 21 days, 3 weeks, and all you can eat is fruits and vegetables. Because you still have to consume. That's what I love about a Daniel fast. You still have to consume. But you're going to have those moments. When you sick of vegetables. Because you can't put all that extra stuff. No ranch dressing. You can't drown it in ranch. Oh, my God. Because what you're doing on a Daniel fast is you're eating for nourishment. Which is God's intention. We made eating about pleasure was never God's intention. Nourishment. It ain't supposed to have to be the best thing to taste so good that to put you in a hole. Come on. I have eaten some stuff that's so good. I said, I don't know if this is from God or from the devil. I don't even know. It's true. It's true. We have to be mindful. Fasting helps us control what you bite. It helps you to subdue the flesh. Put it down. Yes, I want to eat something. I have no idea. I mean, no business, but, oh, woo, Jesus, help me, God. That's why it says fasting and prayer. Can't just do the fasting and prayer. Because you got to call on the Lord when an appetite knocks. If you just fast, then you're dieting. Come on. Come on. The world does fast too, y'all, but it ain't for spiritual reasons. They got their own kind of thing. We ain't gonna get into that. If you're fasting correctly, it births a lifestyle in you. You now can control what you put in your mouth. You can still like that thing, but no, it's not good for you. Proper fasting should birth a lifestyle in you, a discipline, structure. It should give you boundaries. Yes. Yeah. If the first thing you do when you get off your fast is like, girl, I'm about to go over and turn it down at the restaurant. It didn't even birth the lifestyle in you. It's okay, though. Keep going. I'm sorry. Don't be telling no more. It should be birthing self-controlling. Yes, you ain't no skill. Enjoy yourself. There was a man that went on a 40-day fast, no food. Did water and liquids only. Went to Golden Corral, ate everything that wasn't nailed down, and died. Oh. Yes. Because his body wasn't used to digesting all that. He was religiously fasting. Lord, don't just let me be denying this food, but I want to learn to deny my flesh. Lord, give us appetite control in this atmosphere today. Yes, transform our taste buds. May we be able to say, not my will, but your will be done. May we learn to say no to the things we still want to say yes to, God. Purify our taste buds. Oh, Jesus. Purify our taste buds, God. Purify our taste buds, God. Give us a hunger for righteousness. Birth it in us, God, so that it can be manifest in our actions, God. We don't want to just fast. We want to starve the flesh. We don't want the flesh to keep running our life. We don't want worldly desires. We don't want addiction to keep running our life, God. We want a hunger and thirst after righteousness, God. Jesus, without proper appetite control, we can't even be in the world because we're too busy being of it. Yeah. We still look like the world. We still sound like the world. We still have relationship like the world if we don't have proper appetite control. Do for us what we cannot do for ourselves, God. Walk throughout this week with us, oh great God. Give us the strength in our appetite emotionally. Don't let us keep biting off of everything, making us break down and just turn to a pile of nothing, God. Strengthen our emotions. Strengthen us physically, God. mentally, God, spiritually, God.
Jesus.
Not by power, not by might, but only by your spirit. Oh, Jesus. Oh, my God. Oh, Jesus. Oh, God. Oh, Jesus. My God. I want everybody to lift their hands. My God. Ooh, the glory just showed up. Hey, God. Oh, Jesus. My God. Hey, God. Oh, God, we thank you that you're purifying our taste buds. We thank you for your presence, God. We thank you that you're doing it in us today, God. We thank you that you're burning it out today, God. You're burning out every desire that's not like you, God. You're burning it out from the root, God. We bless your name, God. We thank you, Lord. You're so amazing, God. Hey, Lord, we love you on today. Hey, we bless you on today, God. We thank you for doing for us what we cannot do for ourselves, God. We thank you that you are the reminder, God. You are the great purifier, God. Hey, put a coal on our mouth today, God. Hey, just like you did the prophets of old, God. You had to put a coal on their mouth to burn that thing out. My God, purify our tongues today, God. So that we will say what you want us to say, God. So that our words sound like you, God. Give somebody the gift of tongues today, Lord. Allow us to be released today, God. Give somebody a new tongue today, God. We don't want to keep talking in the tongues of the devil. Having a critical spirit. Having a cussing spirit. God, we want to be counted holy. We can't be counted holy. We can't be counted righteous if you don't invade our life, God. If you don't show up in our life, God. If you don't stand up in us today, God. Hey, God, we come today, Lord. Hungry and thirsting after righteousness, God. We want to be made holy, God. We want to be made righteous, God. We want to be perfected in your presence, God. Hey, Lord. We want others to see our lifestyle, God. Without us having to say we are a child of God. We want them to say, what must I do to be saved? We want them to say it's something about you. I know that you don't do like they do. You don't respond like they respond. What is it about you? And we can say it's nothing but the blood of Jesus. God, have your way today. Have your way today, God. Have your way today, God. Now we come today, Lord, asking you to wash us of the residue. Because there are some things that you already closed the door to in our life, God. But the residue is still there, God. It's still there, God. What is the residue? The residue means I stop, God, because you asked me to. But I still like it. Hey, it still calls my name. I didn't do it this week, God, because you told me don't do it. But I still like it. And if you permitted that thing, God, I would do it. I would get into it, God. Today, Lord, burn off the residue of that thing, God. Burn off the residue, God. God, we bless you. We honor you, God. Hey, God. And there's somebody in the room, God, and you burned off the residue, God. But somebody today, Lord, they said, birth a fresh appetite in me today, God. Birth a fresh appetite to me, God. I don't know what to eat. I don't know what to eat. I've been eating that thing all my life. I've been doing that all my life. That's been my place of comfort all my life, God. That's how I've gotten by, God. I don't even understand another way, God. Hey, give me a fresh appetite. Teach me today, Lord. Send your Holy Spirit. You said the Holy Spirit is a teacher.
Jesus.
Teach us what to buy, Lord. Teach us appetite control. Teach us self-control. Teach us when to eat, Lord. Oh, God, we bless you.
My Lord.
We bless you today, God.
Jesus.
We bless you today, God. We bless you today, God. And we thank you for everything that you're doing in this place. In each and every life that's represented today, God. In each and every family that's represented today, God. Oh, Jesus. Hey, God.
Hallelujah.
Cleanse our hands, God. Anything that we've touched.
My Lord.
And it's still with us, God. Cleanse our feet, Lord.
Jesus.
Hey, you said if you don't wash us, we don't belong to you. Everywhere we went this week, we picked up some things, God. Wash us today, God. We want to be counted as holy. We want to be counted as fire. We'll try to put the fire out, and that fire is meant to purify us, God. We'll try to make it stop instead of standing in that thing, God. Ooh, purify us, God. Purify us, God. Strengthen us for the journey. Strengthen us just like you did the three Hebrew boys, Lord. You had strengthened them before they rolled up to the king's palace. My God, that's why they was able to say, y'all eat that, I eat this. My God. Y'all eat that, I eat this. My God, everybody else was doing it. But they made a stand for righteousness. That's why they said, I'm not going to dance to that music. I'm not going to bow to that music. Do what you got to do to me. I trust God. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. If you don't change our appetite, God, we can't even walk in our calling effectively. We'll make you look bad, God. Hey, God, we want to be the example. We want to be the proof that you can truly transform a life. Oh, Jesus. You can truly transform a life. You truly are who you said that you are, God. You said he who is in Christ is a new creation. Old things are passed away. Peace in the name of Jesus. Old things are passed away. Old things are passed away, God. We thank you, Lord, that old things are passed away.
Jesus.
Even in this atmosphere, old things are passed away.
Jesus.
We thank you, Lord, that you're passing them away even now. Even now,
my Lord.
Even now, we're being made new today. We're being made new today. Hey, God, you are the potter and we are the clay, God. You are the author and the finisher of our faith, Lord. Write our stories to be read by many. Ooh. To be read by many. To those that saw us live one way, to our children, to our family, to our co-workers, God, may we be seen as new.
Jesus.
Not by our dress code, not by our hair, God, but by our lifestyle, Jesus.
Yes, yes, yes.
By our responses, God. Oh, Jesus. Hey, we don't want to be earthly minded. We want to respond correctly. You told Peter flesh and blood didn't reveal this to you. But a couple of chapters over, Peter cut a man zero. Because he got under pressure. He got under pressure, God. And he didn't understand it with his spiritual mind. He understood it in the flesh, God. He responded in the flesh to pressure, God. His heart was breaking. They came for his Lord. The very one you just confirmed and said, yes, you hear from God, was the one that responded in the flesh when pressure was applied. Equip us to handle pressure. Ooh. Equip us to walk through, God, the fire, knowing, believing that we're coming out on the other side as pure gold. We won't look like the fire. We won't look like the fight, God.
Yes, yes, yes.
But we're being purified. So uncomfortable, God, but we believe that you're with us. You're shedding things out of our life. You're closing doors, God. We don't even know what it looks like to walk this walk. My God, we're not even comfortable with ourselves without those vices. Oh, but God, we bless you. God, we bless you. God, we bless you. Touch them, Lord. Strengthen them, God. As you're making them new. Oh, Jesus, as you're making them new. The Lord said, I know you don't know this life. I know you don't understand all the nooks and the crannies. Empty out everything that you know. He's trying to fill you up. Fresh knowledge. It's uncomfortable. He's calling you to the uncomfortable. My God, you don't even know what it looks like. You get a change 2-3 times trying to make it feel right to you. It's uncomfortable. Ooh, but God is with you. God is with you. He's trans-
transforming you. Don't fight the process. He's preparing you for something. Just say yes. God, I don't understand. I don't understand everything, God. Hey, strengthen me. Woo! Purify him, Lord, from the top of his head, the soles of his feet, God. Purify him for your purpose, God. Your eyes to see, God. Renew his sight to be, God. So he's not saying, I see men as tall as trees. Lord, you had to touch him again. Touch him again today, God. Give him ears to hear what the Spirit is saying. Ooh, we break that false image out of him. May he see himself as you see him, God. Holy, righteous, man of God. Holy, righteous, man of God. Renewing him a right heart and a clean spirit today. Refresh him, God. Touch his mind, Lord. Let that mind be in him that is in Christ Jesus. Prepare his hands for war, God. Strengthen him, God. Bless him, God. Prepare his feet, God. Everywhere he walks shall be called holy ground. His image shall no longer go before him, but the glory shall make a path. The glory shall make a path. He doesn't have to toot his own horn in this season. My God. You're getting ready to open up doors for him, Lord. You're getting ready to answer his prayers. The Lord says, stay humble. I'm listening because you're being obedient. He said, you have my ear. The choice is yours. Every day, you have to remember, he's saying, choose this day whom you will serve. Choose this day whom you will serve. Every decision is a choice. The devil can't run up on you no more. The choice is yours. The Lord put it in your hands today. Choice between good and evil. Every choice. The choice between good and evil. Your life is closing the door to the enemy for your daughters.
Yes.
For your children to come.
Yes.
You're setting up generational legacy. Yes. He's strengthening your back for the journey.
Yes.
My God, Lord, I bless you today.
Yes.
We honor you today,
yes.
God.
Yes.
God, we bless you. We ask that you keep a hedge of protection around them, Lord, as they grow in you, God. As they begin to lay down their worldly ways, God. As they begin to dive and submerge themselves in you, God. Give them a fresh hunger for righteousness today, God. Give them a fresh hunger for righteousness today, Lord. Fill them afresh today, God. From the top of their head to the soles of their feet, God. Fill them today, God. Afresh, God. Refresh them today. Not by power. Not by might. But only by your Spirit, God. Lord, we bless you today, God. We honor you today, God. May they walk in holiness, God. May they walk in holiness, God. May they remember you are the silent listener on every conversation. Hey, Shreddy, I'm gonna say, you are the third wheel. Come on. Hey, Shreddy, I'm gonna say, may they be bonded and bound in you, God. God, we bless you. God, we honor you. We thank you for their life, God. We thank you for what you're doing in and through them, God. We thank you for the ministry that they are being, that is being birthed in them, Lord. They shall be able to lead other young couples, God. Hey, God. They shall be able to say, yes, it was rough, but we waited. My God. Hey, we had to choose every day. We had to say, not my will, come on, but his will. Hey, Shetty, I'm not at this city. I'm not at this city. They are setting up generational legacy for the children that are to come. Generational legacy. May they never lack. May they never lack. In your will, may they never lack. In your will, may they never lack. In your will, may they never lack. My God. Hey, God. Lord, we bless you. We thank you. In Jesus' name. Whew.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Vanessa, the Lord said, because you showed up. And because he knows it was a press today. Because you showed up despite everything that you're up against. It's uncomfortable. It's hard. My God. Jesus. He said he built you for this. You ain't gonna break. My God, he built you, Jesus. When I see you come to get your hair done, I promise it just blows my mind. He said he built you for that. Nothing in your life has caught God by surprise. He has built you like that. People don't understand it. It's not, you can't even teach it. My God. Woo. He said the same one. It's going to roll down on your children. In due season, be patient. He's birthing patience in you to stand alongside that determination. You got to wait. It's not going to happen tomorrow. You got to wait. But he's building patience to go with your endurance. You got endurance. You got determination. You got drive. But he's building patience. Fresh level of patience for where he's getting ready to take you. And he said, your business is not done. He gave the, that's how you're going to retire. You've worked hard all your life. He's going to give you those days. Your business is going to prosper. When you are ready, it's going to prosper. The next time you start, don't stop. It's going to, you know, I see you sitting down in your rocking chair, chilling. They bring me the checks. You're going to have to lift the finger. Keep enduring. God is with you. Oh, God, we bless you. I want to pray for the kids, and then we'll wrap it up because they can ready to go back to school. Y'all come on up. All the kids.
Jesus, I thank you, Lord. I thank you, God, for each baby that's represented here, oh God. I thank you, Lord, for each purpose, God, each legacy, God, each family, God, each generation that's going to be broken, Father God. Each walk, Father God, each church, Father God, each business, Father God, my God, each ministry, Father God. I thank you, Lord, for what's represented in these childs, Father God. For your word said in the last days that young men shall dream dreams. My God, and that the babies will be dreaming, Father God. So, Lord, I pray that you strengthen them now, Father God, from the crown of the head to the soles of their feet, Father God. Lord, I pray that you will renew their strength, God. For your word says, train up a child in the way that they should go, and they shall not turn from it, Father God. Lord, I pray that you send teachers the way, Father God, from their parents, Father God, to the school, Father God, to everywhere their feet shall tread, Father God. I pray that you bring divine connection to each child represented in this place, Father God. Lord, I pray you send your angels to being captured all around about them, oh God. Lead them in everywhere they go, Father God. Lord, I pray that you speak to them even now, Father God, and begin to plant seeds, Jesus, that would come forth, Father God, in the next seasons of their life, Father God. Lord, wrap your loving, comforting arms around them, Father God. Lord, help them, Father God, to stay fixated on you no matter what comes up against them in this world, Jesus. Lord, prepare their hearts and their minds as they go back to school, Father God. Prepare their hearts and their minds as we go through these world crises, Father God. Prepare them, Father God, to know that they don't have to wear a face mask, Father God. That they don't have to have a book, Father God. That they don't have to have a pencil, Father God. But if they got the Holy Spirit that dwells in us each and every day, that they got more than enough to overcome the whole wide world, Jesus. Lord, I pray that you would touch each and every one of them in the way that they need to be touched, Father God. That you would strengthen them up, Father God, to move forward in what you're going to do in them in this season, Father God. Lord, I pray that every word that is spoken over them, Father God, will come to pass, Father God. Any curses over them, I rebuke it now in the name of Jesus. I come against every word curse, Father God. I come against every plan, plot, and seed of the enemy over them right now, God, in the name of Jesus. Lord, send your healing wings now, Father God, to cover them, God. Lord, I pray that you come against any generational curse, Father God, that would try to trap them, Father God, in the plots of the enemy, Father God. For you said you knew them before you formed them in their mother's womb, Jesus. So, Lord, I pray that just like you knew them then, Father God, that you teach them to know you in that same way now, Father God. And it is so. In the name of Jesus, I do pray. Amen.
Amen.
Women, nobody move. Everybody come back. Hey, Demetrius, focus. Listen, y'all children, look behind you. You ain't by yourself.
Yes.
The Lord said his people standing for you.
Yes.
People praying for you.
Yes.
You ain't by yourself. by yourself. You ain't standing by yourself. You got an arm. My Lord. If God be with you, he's greater than the world against you. Corona can't get you.
Come on.
I don't care what they say.
Corona
can't get you. Boys ain't bigger than God.
Yeah.
And math is hard, but it ain't bigger than God. Lord, we thank you for today.
Yes, God.
We thank you for today, Lord, and everything that was done in this place, God. Be with us as we leave this place, but never from your presence. We want to leave, we'll leave you an opportunity to sow into the ministry. If you want to sow, y'all can go back to your feet if you'd like to. Also, before I send the final choir closing, I want to say a special thank you to my son, because he made my day so good yesterday. He brought his mama some red roses. Bring him in here so y'all can see him, y'all. He gave me them red roses, and he bought it with his own money and everything, y'all. Just blessed my soul so good. Yes, that's my baby child right there. Ooh, come on, y'all. Lord, be with us as we leave this place, but never from your presence. In Jesus' name, hallelujah. We'll see y'all back here Friday at 8. Amen.